This E3 coverage is brought to you by Ting, mobile that makes sense.
I feel like you probably get offered weed a lot.
Yeah, I do.
In your day to day?
It's definitely, especially when I was on tour, people would like throw blunts and joints on stage.
Like with a bow and arrow? So, Cray, hey. Is that what I'm supposed to call you, Cray?
Call me Cray, Cray
Sean. Cray Sean,
that's
the full name?
That's what I prefer.
You prefer the extended formal name.
Yes.
Cool. Well, we got you into E3 this year. Huh. This is your first E3.
This is my first convention
period?
Type thing mm-hmm.
yeah.
ever.
But it's made sense, I think, because you are someone who likes video games a lot. You've been streaming on Twitch as GamerMom420 a little bit from time to time.
That's a good name, by
really
the way.
Good
that
name.
Is amazing.
So yeah, you primarily stream Nintendo stuff, right?
Yeah.
So we kind of made a beeline together for Nintendo's booth.
Yeah,
you see
that
anything
was fun.
You thought was cool there?
I was like really excited to play Yarn Yoshi.
Yeah.
It was really...
Yeah, they gave that game a new name this year. It's like Yoshi's Woolly World or something.
Yeah, but wasn't it Yarn Yoshi?
It was definitely called Yarn Yoshi before,
That's way more fluid than Woolly
World. Yeah, it's nice and short, Yarn Yoshi. Gets right to the point.
Yeah, Woolly World just reminds me of Wally World.
Something about it sounds very like scrotomy and also
scrotomy?
It's a little scrotomy.
That's a word.
The game itself is pretty dope, I thought.
Yeah, was good.
What did you like most about Yarn Yoshi, which is what I'm going to keep calling it?
I just like the yarn aspect.
Yeah.
It was like, the graphics were like yarn. It's awesome. You could get so dimensional with the crocheting, you know?
What's your favorite Nintendo game of all time?
Ooh,
big question.
Favorite Nintendo game? I mean, like...
I assume your favorite game is a Nintendo game, probably.
But what I was thinking today would be so cool if they brought back the Game Boy camera game, mm-hmm. but like for the DS.
It makes a lot of sense. I mean, like literally every Nintendo
device.
Because
they had like the printer and everything. That one was really good because you can make beats on there.
Yes.
You can take pictures and print them out.
Uh-huh. The sound mixer.
There was so much just little stuff about that game.
It seems like the type of thing they would do.
I guess that would be my favorite.
Because the 3DS has a camera.
Other than Animal Crossing.
Animal Crossing is dope. Have you played the new one? The
New Leaf.
3DS one? Yeah. We've also both been playing Tomodachi Life a little bit,
Tomodachi
which is super
Life
weird.
Is really awesome.
Yeah.
Like, are you guys friends in the game?
We are.
We live in each other's buildings.
We do. Right? We do. We're roommates.
That's sweet.
On the internet. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that game is wild, dude. Like,
I'm the least popular person on my island.
Oh yeah, like, when you go in there.
I have zero friends. I'm all the way at the bottom of every ranking. Aww.
When I moved Tara into my town, me was like, hey, I'm thinking about going and meeting Nick and being friends with him. And Tara was like, absolutely not. And didn't say no. So my knee's like at the bottom three, too. Nobody wants to be friends with mine.
My me is a huge bitch.
Yeah, so that game is weird because there's not a lot of playing to it. It's mostly
you can't control. Yeah, you can't be like, I want this person to meet this person.
Nah.
It's kind of all like fate. You know, it's like what real life is.
It is like real life.
Fate.
And just like in real life, Tara is about to start dating Shaq.
Really?
I loaded Shaq into my game and he's down.
That's
so.
The best I could hope for, I feel.
Yeah.
In real life and in a video.
At the
game.
Very least, it's the best you could hope for on Waluigi Island, which is the name of my island. Shaq is by far the hottest dude on the island.
Oh yeah.
Just like me and Anthony Carboni and like
sounds boring.
Tingle from Legend of Zelda. There's not a lot of winners on that island.
I feel like that's true of a lot of Nintendo games, that there's not a whole lot of like gameplay. Like I played Animal Crossing New Leaf for a couple months, like pretty hardcore. And after a while, it's just like, what am I doing here?
Mm. Yeah,
like,
you get in a little circle.
Yeah, you develop like this existential crisis where you're like, what's going on? Like, what's the purpose? What's the greater meaning in this?
Yeah.
I still don't know.
Fully. Checking every day for the new furniture to complete your apartment look.
See, that's kind of what I like about Tomodachi Life is that it feels like Animal Crossing, but with some of the trivial stuff you have to do taken out. So you're not like, shaking trees for fruit, although there's something very relaxing about that. But in Tomodachi Life, it's just the conversations.
Hunting beetles
at
night.
That's the part I didn't like about New Leaf. I don't care what other people have to say. I just want to like pick weeds and harvest apples.
Pick weeds all day. So what did you like most about Animal Crossing? What makes it your favorite Nintendo franchise?
I like games where you're like a person and you do things. You know, like I'm not like into fighting games that much unless it's like just one-on-one combat with your friend versus not like I'm going through the town trying to save the princess.
Yeah.
But Mario's cool.
That was
like the wrong analogy for what I was trying to say.
That's one example.
But yeah,
of that,
I like The Sims. Like I think The Sims was like one of the first games that I really like started obsessing over like I was hours and hours.
Super into The Sims in high school. I had the Hot Date expansion pack, and I would just make my Sims like do it all day long.
Yeah.
Because I was not getting any action back then. So I was like, this is how I have to live vicariously.
Yeah.
There is something cool about games that, like, you can do a million games about heroes saving the world and shooting with guns, but there's something kind of neat about life simulation or, like, living a life that you never will exactly.
Well, I just got into, like, well, not just. I tried to get into Second Life, but I think I was, like, too late. I think that ship, like, that's what everyone was like. Yeah. I was like, I'm new on here. Everyone's like, okay.
I've been here for 17
How old
years.
Are you? You know? Like,
yeah, that was super popular when I was in college, like 8 years ago or something. Yeah.
That game's vibes, like.
There are still people who, Phil Fish's wife actually makes a living just creating, like, skins and stuff for Second Life.
Oh, yeah, you can, like, sell stuff on there.
Yeah, you can totally make stuff and sell it, and people will buy that
shit
all day long.
I saw it on Netflix. They had, like, a documentary on it.
Yeah.
Called Second Life 2.0.
Was it about how it like ruins people's lives?
It was about like how it was like thriving and everyone was like making money and like it was a whole community.
It's an own economy.
And then like somebody like hacked everything and made everything free.
Yeah.
And then it just like fucked over everyone's life.
Wow. Jesus. I do remember hearing a story about some woman who made like over $1 million on it.
That cloud money is real, man.
Yeah, like people would like buy a house in there and then she would buy up every single lot around that house and like build enormous mountains around it. So she was essentially like blocking people into their homes.
Jeez.
And then she would like, they would have to pay a bunch of money to her and it was like total blackmail and shit.
Whoa.
Like, I don't know if that qualifies as blackmail,
that's
but it was
so
fucked
awesome.
Up.
That's kind of dope, yeah.
Yeah.
She's kind of like
a
pirate.
It's like an internet pirate.
Right.
Yeah. A real life internet pirate.
A real life internet pirate. You ever do that thing in Animal Crossing where you go to the island and just collect as much bugs as possible because you can sell them for a whole lot? Mm-hmm. Like that exploit?
Yeah, what you gotta do is you just chop down all the trees and leave one on each side. Mm-hmm. So you just walk back and forth and it reloads a new bug.
Really?
Jeez, that is some serious man. You could make like hell of bells that
way. I did. That's why the game got kind of old, because like I just was balling out with the bells.
Too much money.
Yeah.
Start burying it places. Become an eccentric Animal Crossing millionaire.
Yeah.
There are things about that game that I just don't understand. Like, the fact that you can't, like when you pick something up, you have to put it, like specifically drag it into your inventory and stuff. Like, why Nintendo? Why?
I always have too many items.
They should have people pay. Can you pay now to upgrade your backpack or whatever?
Nah, but I was thinking about finding someone on the internet and paying them some real world money to come in and clean up all the weeds in my town and like make my town.
Really?
I was like, yeah, I'll PayPal you $15 if you
want
to come
in. I'll do
that. Yeah?
Fuck
come
yeah,
pull
I love
my
pulling
weeds. Perfect. That's a symbiotic relationship right there.
Yeah, that was the most fun part of Animal Crossing for me. I'm not even joking.
There's something about it, it's just like...
Yeah. I'll never weed my own lawn in real life, but I will do it hardcore.
Well, because when you weed it in real life, it doesn't make like a cool sound.
No, it's nowhere near as satisfying.
It's not as easy, yeah. It's like popping a pimple.
Mm. Right, it is a lot like that. Similar...
Somebody should make a video game about popping a pimple.
Maybe.
They do, they have it.
We were talking...
Really?
Yeah, it's an app game.
Oh, God.
I don't know if I'm ready to go down that rabbit hole.
I can't even watch YouTube videos of that.
No. Ugh. My roommate does, though.
What? That's so weird.
I know.
It's weird to me that people do that. It's gross.
One time I had a zit on my face, and my roommate was like, he was like chasing me around the house. He's like, let me watch you.
That's how my mom
is. Let me watch you pop it. I'm like, dog, no, I'm not going to do that. That's the grossest thing anyone's ever. Like, no, I would have if you
like. My mom would like force me.
I'm never going to do it now.
She would like pin me down and like pop it.
Oh my God. Wow. I mean, it's satisfying when you do it to yourself. But
not on someone else.
Not on someone else. It's gross.
It's nightmarish.
I don't even think I can do that to my own son.
I can't look at it.
Shut it down.
Hey, there is a ton of awesome video games coming out this year, and if you want the money to actually buy all the games you want, then you should sign up for Ting.
Yeah, Ting is this alternative sort of version of a cell phone provider plan that doesn't require you to lock yourself into a painful 2-year contract and makes you only pay for what you use each month. So let's say 1 month you leave your phone at home and go on vacation, you won't pay any data fines and minutes.
Yeah, you only pay for what you use. There's no long-term plans. You don't have to pay any crazy hidden fees like you always have to do with your cell phone provider. It puts the power back in your hands and it is completely transparent. They will show you everything that you have used and all of your charges. No hidden fees, no crazy stuff like that. And they have awesome customer service. If you call up Ting, you will actually speak to a real live human being,
right,
which
away.
Is unheard of.
In this day and age?
No robots.
You kidding me?
Exactly.
I'm over robots.
So if you want to sign up for Ting, or if you want to check out their savings calculator, which can show you how much money you would save over 2 years if you switch to Ting, just hit up rev3games.ting.com. And if you sign up with that link, you'll also get $25 off your first monthly bill. Again, that is rev3games.ting.com. And remember, every sign up helps support Rev3 Games.